Hello everybody. So today I would like to discuss how to schedule and join a Zoom class or meeting. So this will definitely help you to create a meeting and also how to join for a scheduled meeting. So let's see. So once you download the Zoom application, you'll get an icon like this on your desktop. So just double click this. It will open the Zoom module. As you can see, there are major four modules available here: new meeting, join, schedule, and share screen. So for teachers, this share screen option, it is not required as of now. So I will discuss the remaining three. New meeting means if you want to create a new meeting on a sudden mode. For example, if you want to meet all the HODs together, you can just click here and you can just share this number. We can call it as the meeting ID, and we can start a meeting without any prior scheduling. So that is about the new meeting facility. Join, it is used for already joined or already created meeting. Schedule, it is used for schedule a meeting for a future purpose. So before moving into the schedule, I would like to discuss some more points. You can see some options available here: home, chat, meeting, and contacts. So this is the home screen. And when you click on the chat option, you can see the chat messages. If you have already did some chats, you can see the chats over here. Here there is no chats available, so that's why it's empty. And click on the meeting, you can see two tabs. One is upcoming meeting and other tab is recorded meeting. The upcoming meeting, it is the scheduled meeting for the future. So this meeting, it's already over. So it's today's meeting, that's why it is mentioned over here. When you click on the recorded option, you can see April 1st I conducted a meeting, and also today also I conducted two meetings. So you can see this. When you click here, you can see the corresponding status and the recording too. It's available here. You can play from here, or you can just open the corresponding file. We can share it also, and if you want, you can delete. The fourth option is contacts. So it is to create four channels. So as of now, no need to create the channels for the normal classrooms, so I'm not mentioning here. Coming back to the home, so here you can see the schedule option. So when you click on the schedule, you will get a page like this, schedule meeting. So by default, you will get the page with your name. For example, Anil Kumar M's Zoom meeting. So you can just delete this and you can specify the topics. So you can say computer networks. So you can schedule a meeting for future. That is, I would like to schedule a meeting on 6th Monday, and I prefer the time 9 o'clock. And the duration also of the meeting also you can mention here: 15 minutes, 30 minutes, 45 minutes. So if you specify 45 minutes, you'll get a warning. The Zoom basic plan has a 40 minute time limit on meeting with three or more participants. There is an option to upgrade now. If you click on the upgrade now button, it will automatically redirect it to the payment page. So no need of this. If you want don't want to see this, you can just uncheck this and you can submit. And there is an option called recurring. So recurring, if you want to continue the meeting for the coming days, you can just click on this recurring mode. Otherwise, no need to click on it. And for the purchased option, we can create our own personal meeting ID, but here it will generate the automatic ID. The only difference is if you click on the generate automatically option, the password the system will automatically generate. If you click on the personal meeting, you can specify the corresponding password. And this video option, it is based on the host video mode. So here there are two options, host video on and host video off. So this option we can change after scheduling also, so don't worry about this. And participants video on off options also we can schedule like this. If you want to switch on all the participants video, you can state here. And you can just mention the audio part. Automatically it is selected as telephone and computer audio, so you can go with this, no issue. And the calendar option, by default it will select the Google calendar. As you can see that my Gmail is automatically connected, so it's better to use the Google calendar. Then under the advanced option, there are four subunits: enable waiting room. So for a scheduled class, this enable waiting room facility, no need to check it out, because this is applicable if you are conducting a webinar. Because you are forwarding your link to your friends and we don't know how many persons are joining for the meeting. So in that situation, we can use this. But enable join before host, this option you can enable, because the users can check the different modes, or users can check before the meeting also. Then mute participants on entry. This is sometimes very important, because if you want to start a class without any interruption, you can mute this in advance, so the members are not supposed to switch on their microphones. And automatically record meeting on the local computer. It will automatically record the corresponding sessions to your local PC. If you are a paid customer, there is an option to save your entire contents in cloud. But here I am using the basic version, so if I check this option, automatically it will save all the documents in my documents folder, or you can just specify the external devices too. And just click on the schedule. So when you click on the schedule, the Zoom automatically schedule the corresponding session. Just a minute. It will ask for the corresponding account information. Sometimes you can just click on the corresponding mail ID. I already connected to the Google calendar, that's why automatically it redirected to the Google calendar. And if you want to add any additional feature, you can just mention over here. Otherwise you can skip this page. It is not compulsory to use this page. It will automatically redirect you to the Google page. So go back to the corresponding page. So you can just click on the meetings. You can see the meeting is scheduled. So if you want to see the invitation, you can see the invitation here. Either you can just copy from here, or just click on the copy invitation and you can just paste in WhatsApp or through mail. So this is the basic structure of creating the classroom. So I would like to tell you one more point. There is an option called settings here. So when you click on the settings, you can see different options like general video, then audio, share screen, chat, virtual background. The virtual background, it is applicable if you don't have a proper background. You just click here. You can see my video here. So if you want to change the background, you can just click on the available virtual background. Automatically it will change the background. So here I have already the curtain, so the blank space, it is automatically reflected the session. You can see this. And if you want to choose this, you can choose this. If you want to choose this, you can choose this. Okay, or if you want some other picture, you can use that picture option also. If you are sitting in a perfect room, no need of any additional facilities. The recording option also, there are lots of options. You can just specify the local recording where you are supposed to save. And the additional options also mentioned here. It is very simple. You can just go through it, and if you want to check it, you can check it. Otherwise, you can uncheck it. So here you can just mention your profile, and if you want to upgrade to professional version, you can just upgrade and do the payment for monthly basis or for a session wise. Then the chat option also, you can just mention the corresponding chat windows. So here you can just check the push notification for the private and public chats, and unread messages also we can just mention over here. And if you don't want to disturb in between, you can just do all the notifications here. So share screen also, there are lots of additional facilities like maximizing the screen and all. And audio option and video option, you can just cross check over here. So it will also help you to do it in a perfect manner. So the video also you can check, and if it is perfectly okay, definitely you can go forward. And under the general option, you can see the reaction, skin tones, you can check, and you can give the notification, remind me before 5 minutes of all upcoming meetings, and use dual monitors. So these all options are available. So stop my video and audio when my display is off and screensaver begins. So if you check on this option, definitely it will work based on that. So after doing all these settings, if you want to see more settings, you can click on the more settings, and you can do all the necessary things. But for basic version, it is not available. So just close this window, automatically it will save, and you can go for the meeting. I would like to share one more point. After a meeting, you can see, I already mentioned that the meeting, if you want to record, already the recorded video and audio, it is available here in the Zoom cloud. By default, almost 1 GB space it is provided for the Zoom meeting. If you are conducting a 30 to 40 minute meeting, 150 to 170 MB space required for saving the documents. And I would like to share one more point. So I'm just taking the recording page. You can see, so under the Zoom window, you can see the recording option with the caption. The first recording I just mentioned, the personal meeting room. So these two recordings based on that. And in the second meeting, that is today's meeting, I just mentioned self-directed learning. So two sessions we conducted based on that, two folders it's created. I just open one folder. You can see this is the video. So this is a 30 minute video, so it's approximately 141 MB. And if you want to hear only the sound, you can just copy the sound option, that is only audio, that is it's nearly 12 MB. And I'll show you very interesting option. When you click on the audio record, it will record the audio separately. That is, when you are taking a class, if your students are asking questions, so you can keep track of the students. Who all are actively participating in the class and who all are not responding. So like that you can see from this audio record option. And also you can see the chat window. So under this chat window, the teacher can see, or the host can see, all the corresponding notifications. If it is a private chat or a public chat, we can see all the corresponding chat options. So these all things it will automatically record, and depends upon the memory space, we can save the documents either in our personal laptop or an external drive. So these are the major applications of Zoom. So of course we can use the schedule option and join option for the class mode, and the daily updates. This is the notification area, so no upcoming meetings today. So on 6th, the corresponding meetings will be displayed here, and it will definitely help you to conduct the sessions in a very easy manner, and definitely you must practice 5 or 6 times before the actual session. It will definitely help you to do the Zoom application in an efficient manner. So thank you so much. Thank you for watching the video.